Hey guys, so this video is going to be super hard for me to get through because it's a very touchy subject. I've known about this news for about a month and it's taken me this long to be able to share it on camera. Here we go. So if you guys have watched part one to this video, I explained all of my diseases. So my mom was researching and she came across this disease, which is called cervical cranial instability. We went to Arizona Children's Hospital, and they said, we don't know how to test for cervical cranial instability. And even if she had it, there's nothing we can do for that. We kept researching CCI, and we found a doctor who specializes in CCI, who does surgeries for them. So we had a video chat with him. He took my scans from the hospital from Arizona, and he could see that I did have CCI with those old scans. I got diagnosed with cervical cranial instability. He said I am one of the worst cases he has ever seen. He said that I'm lucky my neck hasn't snapped yet, and he said that I'm lucky I haven't died yet, and that was really, really hard news to hear. I am one of the worst cases he has ever seen. My head is basically a bobblehead. When I don't have this on, which is like when I'm sleeping, my head falls to the side. I have three things going on with the CCI. So I have the unstable neck. My neck cannot hold up my head. It cannot support it. Over time, all the ligaments and tendons tore. And so my neck cannot hold up my head, and that is why it could snap. So I have to be super careful, and I cannot do makeup anymore. But I do have pre-filmed videos from before, and so there are different measurements that the doctor looked at, and all of them were really bad. So this is normal, this is people with CCI, and mine was like down here. Also, my brain compresses on my spinal cord, which is super painful. It causes really bad head pain, really bad neck, back, and shoulder pain, sleep apnea, balance issues. Where my head and neck meet, that bone pokes in. And it causes really high CSF pressure. It causes so much high pressure in my head, and it blocks off the blood flow. So that is really, really painful when that happens. And the reason that I have this neck issue is because I have another disease which is called Ehlers-Danlos syndrome, and that is instability in my entire body, so it makes my ligaments and like my bones more weak. That's what caused my CCI. He said that I'm going to need a very, 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 very risky invasive surgery. I have known about this for about a month, so I've just kind of gathered my thoughts. I'm still not that familiar with CCI, and I don't want to know that much information about the surgery. We leave on August 20th, so it's coming up, and I'm getting really scared, honestly. So first, what we're going to do, we're going to get to New York. I'm going to fly in an airplane that like lays all the way flat, because with the turbulence and everything, oh, it's going to be a nightmare with my neck. Sorry, I can't swallow right now because my bones is poking in. So when we get to New York, the first surgery I'm having done is basically it will mimic what the main surgery will do. So they're going to put two screws and bolts in my head, and they're going to pull up my head in the proper position that it's supposed to be in, and then they're going to wake me up. And if I feel relief, like if I don't feel as much pain with my neck and head, then they are going to go on with the main surgery. And if I don't feel relief, then I honestly do not even know what we are going to do. This is our last hope. So, the main surgery. It's going to be this big of an incision. They're going to cut from the back of my head all the way down to my neck, like to the bottom of my neck. And they are going to go in and position my head the right way and put bolts and screws in. I watched a video about the surgery, about the neurosurgeon. If they move their hand like a little bit too far to the left or right, I could be paralyzed. And it's really scary to think about because, you know, people have died from this surgery. And I don't want to start thinking about all that because then I get like really bad anxiety about it. But I mean, it's really scary. Like, this is a major, major brain and neck surgery. Like, they are cutting into my bones and my head. They are cutting into my brain. And the doctor said I would be worried if you weren't nervous about this surgery. And it's going to take 8 hours. You know, I'm really nervous about it. I don't want to know all the scary details about it, so I'm just telling you guys as much as I know. And if they see, like, my brain compressing and the poking in of my bone in the back, if they see that they need to fix that, then I will have a third surgery for that. The main surgery, which is where they fix my neck, that recovery is 6 months. And he said, I've seen people who had the surgery before, and they said they were in excruciating pain. Like, I'm really nervous for when I wake up from the surgery. The surgeon said it's 50% on him and 50% on me. And I'm willing to do whatever it takes to feel a little bit better because I physically cannot handle living like this anymore. I am in excruciating pain. You guys don't even know. Like, I'm trying so hard to hold back tears and not to show it, but I'm having really bad back pain, neck pain, head pain. It's really bad, and I'm up all night from my pain, but I know I have to get this video up before my surgery so everyone knows what's going on. And I'm going to be kind of vlogging my whole journey. So the first surgery, the halo, then the main surgery, my recovery. So you guys will be in the journey with me. We are going to be in New York for at least a month. And then it is a 6 month recovery. I feel so bad because we're going to be in the hospital for my mom's birthday. But I won't be able to do anything for my birthday. I won't be able to do anything. I won't even be able to move at all for the first 3 months. Once we hit the 4th month mark, then I can get out of bed and walk around. But I have to leave my neck brace on for a really long time just to make sure everything holds. It's really scary to think about that surgery, but all my symptoms are so bad that I'm desperate. I will do anything to make them feel better. Like, I have severe head and neck pain. I hear cracking and popping noises in my head. My head and neck shift, and it's just horrible. From my brainstem compressing, it can cause paralysis. It can cause really scary things, and my neck could snap at any moment, and, you know, it's really scary to think about, because if I were to keep doing the trapeze, I wouldn't be here right now. I would have died, and, you know, my body was telling me to stop when I was freezing up on my doubles. I know I won't be able to do the trapeze anymore, but honestly, I'm in hell right now. And I need to get back up to earth. Like, if I can just get some of this pain to go away, then I will be ecstatic. So, I will still have all my diseases, but my pain won't be as bad with this part. My pain won't be as bad, but I'll still have my other diseases. There is a chance that it won't give me relief, which I'm really nervous about, and there is a chance that I will need more surgeries just like that because they can't go all the way from the top of my head to the bottom of my spine, and those are the areas that are affected for me. I'm just trying to stay really positive. I'm trying really hard to keep faith, but I've just been let down so many times. But, you know, I know that God performs miracles because He did when I was born. I mean, He brought me back to life. So I know He didn't do that for nothing, and I'm really hoping that this all goes well because I'm really scared for it. This is our last hope, but I'm trying to stay as positive as I can. And my grandma recently passed away, and I know she's looking out for me and heaven. I'm in so much pain right now, so I'm going to end the video here. Sorry guys, I'm in too much pain to do shoutouts right now, but I just want to thank you, the person watching right now, for all of your support. And I want to thank all of my followers and subscribers for being there with me, and you guys are part of this journey with me. You guys have accomplished so many things with me, and I really hope this can be an achievement that all of you share with me. Thank you for all your love and support, and I will see you guys in my next video. Bye!